is filled with tourists, people who do not speak a word of English.
And that's exactly why we brought the translator on board. The person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, let's sing, if you have learned every language available, your last job before this one was translating for the United Nations. So why don't you tell the Japanese people to run? in Japanese. That's right. Oh yeah, don't forget the Italians, eh?
I don't know.
And Russians. They're quiet people, those Russians. And roping, because the waves are making up more and more. They're now 5 and 7 foot high. Take them up and down. Up and down. If you take a look on the left shore right now, you will see
a big white wave.
Yes, right on the shore. Sorry. But if you take a look right up ahead, you will see a huge rock, and that rock has a name. That's right. It was named that by the Indians. The actual Ikawika rock translation for that is. And Captain was implementing straight for the big rock. I think we need to make some maneuvers. Tell the team which side to row on.
Row right.
And everybody row right and right and right for Japanese friends.
What?
For the Japanese friends, right.
Right?
Yes. And the Swedes. They're quiet people. And the Russians.
I don't know.
Who cares about the rest? Captain, the right's not working. Maybe we should try the left.
Okay.
Tell the team!
The left.
Tell the tourists.
The left.
They all speak English these days. Good job, team. We have just missed the Ika Rock. Oh. Oh. And don't stop rowing, because the waves are picking up more and more. They're not 20.